For the first couple of weeks of my stay in Venezuela, I found myself looking at my environment with caution. Everyone seemed like a potential threat. But that changed on a small beach called Patanemo. It wasn't a particularly beautiful day, but there was a group of young kids that didn't seem to care. This moment here in Patanemo was the first time I was able to fully disprove the little doubt that I had in my mind about Venezuela. As much as it's irrational to believe that a whole country can be dangerous, there's that side of you that is still unsure until you actually see it with your own eyes. So watching these kids run around the beach, doing somersaults, jumping out of trees, and watching the adults join in, it was comforting to see that because it showed me that there was normalcy. And I remember just standing there watching these kids and being just so happy. So I started to make these little videos and share these moments, and I really didn't think too much about it. But that's when I started to receive messages from people living in Venezuela who wanted to show me more of what their life looks like. Paola was the first person I met up with, and she showed me the more modern side of Valencia. While having my first polarcita, I learned how dramatically more expensive all goods have become, yet how wages have stayed depressed. Asil and Jota invited me to Puerto Cabello and gave me a glimpse into Venezuela's complicated history.
Yeah.
This is where the Spanish influence still is.
Mm-hmm.
Spanish or Portuguese, or both?
I think more Spanish than Portuguese.
Bueno.
Whether it was Paola's pursuit of a career as a singer, or Asil and Jota's pursuit of photography and videography, what they all had in common was a desire to make the most of what they had. It was around this time that I received a message by a guy named Ramon.
Now, honestly, Ramon, if you're listening to this, I'm sorry, but I'm gonna put you on blast.
This is what he sent me. This Saturday is the baseball classic of Venezuela, Caracas versus Magallanes. And it's here in Valencia. Let me see if I can get a ticket for you to come with me and my friends. This game is like a Yankees versus Boston game. It's a huge and important event. And honestly, when I got that message, I was in. But I really had no idea how big the rivalry between Magallanes and Leones really was until I showed up at the game. I want you to look around and soak in this environment. If you don't have a VR headset, move your phone around to look at the whole stadium. Passion doesn't even describe the emotions in this packed stadium. I'm pretty sure the game went to 10 or 11 innings, and four of those were an all-out brawl.
Oh,
I know I'm going to make a lot of enemies by saying this, but I have to. After this game, I was a Magallanero. This was the day my friendship with Ramon and all of his friends began, and I started to use Valencia as my home base. Paola had recommended me to visit Barquisimeto, so when my host's friend invited me to a mysterious place on the way called Sorte, I hitched a ride with them. Some Venezuelans told me that Sorte is where gory ceremonies take place and people get bewitched, but whenever I asked if they've been themselves, the answer was always no, so I went to go see for myself. And I'm not gonna lie, I did see some curious things.
Why is it so skinny?
It turns out that there are many religions that worship these mountains, and both of my host's friends practiced something different. But what they both had in common was that they smoked cigars.
Y tabaco es para
lectura, o sea, visualizar, ver futuro y presente y pasado.
De ti o todo.
De quien sea.
Okay, entonces, ¿qué mira?
Lo que.
O es el nuevo posible para.
Yo no, es el que es la evidencia.
Ah, ok. Entonces, cultura de Venezuela.
Ah, palabra cierta, ¿viste? Se te cayó.
Mejor, pero va a aclarar el futuro de Venezuela.
Sí, pero con pureza, porque no te vas a
pensar. Sí, sí, porque sí, es un blanco.
¿Ah?
Ahora sí, ahora sí lo
entiendo. Eso era yo con la aerolatea.
Yeah, それは分かったけど、solo よくなるだけ。
Venezuela.
Depende de qué.
Venezuela lo que tiene es una maldición de cosas malas que han hecho los gobiernos.
Ajá.
Sí, de manera.
Okay.
Hasta que no nadie, hasta que el karma no decide, Venezuela no se va.
After being left with more questions than answers, we headed deeper into the mountain to a waterfall. They told me this is where they take a bath with special ointments and herbs, but while I waited for them to prepare, I explored a bit deeper into the forest. I'm not sure what was in the potion we used to bathe in, but it included a wide range of yellow and purple flowers, as well as a thick syrup that looked like honey. I'm honestly curious to know a bit more about the religions surrounding Sorte and the rituals that take place, so if you know anything, let me know. After spending an afternoon in the mountain, they dropped me off in Barquisimeto. I had no idea how long I would stay or what I would do. But when you have no plan, anything is possible. And that's how I met the most kind and hardworking man named Antonio.